Hey everyone, welcome back to the Mile Maverick channel, and here we talk about cryptocurrencies and everything crypto. Now, today we're going to talk about Dogecoin and meme coins and Shiba Inu. So why am I talking about Dogecoin and Shiba Inu before you get distressed? Like, why is this guy talking about meme coins? Well, you understand that everything has been packaged in complexity. The way Bitcoin started with the cyberpunk kind of idea of democratization of money controlling, everyone's going to control their own money and we're going to take it away from the government and so on. Yeah, so, but this is all wrapped in mathematics, in algorithms, in Byzantine fault tolerance algorithms, a whole bunch of stuff that people don't want to deal with. So essentially, okay, let's backtrack a little bit. Why is YouTube successful? Why is Instagram successful? Why is Snapchat successful? And why, of all of them, is TikTok successful? A very new technology. It's simplicity. You have a platform that supports people launching funny stuff, funny videos, albeit almost dumb videos. And it's so easy to consume, so easy to understand. It grabs your attention. You click on it. It's the amalgamation of memes. It's amalgamation of cleverly designed thumbnails. The combination of all of this combined with fun and jokes. And this is why this platform is extremely successful. Which is TikTok, and that's why YouTube, Instagram, and many other platforms, if not all of them, WhatsApp and so on, are adopting the TikTok model. So we have Bitcoin, which comes up with this very smart way of solving the money problem, or rather a consensus algorithm that solves something called the Byzantine fault tolerance through a proof of work mechanism. And then you have this community that comes up and says, hold on, we have these two engineers, one from IBM, the other from Adobe. They're like, hey, let's spin up this joke.
You know, you get attention for being the creator, but literally, I don't know what I'm doing. I made a coin in 4 hours and I threw it out there. It's like, literally.
If everyone's going to make a coin, why don't we just make the most ridiculous coin known to mankind?
Of a coin in a few days, let's code up something. You know, let's fork Bitcoin and let's create this thing we call a Dogecoin. A meme coin. We're going to base it off. We're going to take
fly by night cryptocurrency attempt. I guess it was a match made in heaven.
To something more consumable. In other words, communities are going to form. We're going to wrap this thing in bad grammar.
Let's just say there's a heavy emphasis on the words much, very, so, such, and many, written in broken English as if the animal is speaking to himself in his head.
We're going to sponsor F1 races.
Talladega, let's sponsor him.
This is something that I never expected to happen. Like, how did it get so viral and so big so fast?
Looking at the car, we're like, we did this.
But all this is going to be happening on a decentralized scale. What do we mean by decentralized? In other words, no one entity controls Dogecoin, but it's a whole bunch of millions of billions of tokens, actually, that are distributed across the internet at a low price, which handles some of the most fundamental problems in crypto, like scalability. So if you have a bunch of tokens that are at a low price, it means they'll ideally be scalable, because also Dogecoin has a yearly issuance of about 50 or 5 billion tokens around there. So it keeps the price affordable low enough. Well, I mean, in the previous, about a year and a half ago, we had the whole meme coin craze blowing up in our faces, mostly fronted or accelerated by Elon Musk, going crazy, saying that Dogecoin is going to take over the world and taking Dogecoin to Twitter and to the rest of and to the moon, literally. To the moon, Dogecoin. So this led the price of Dogecoin to actually reach a level that no one had predicted before, which was 70 cents. We have Bitcoin that also reached $60,000. But that's not what we're talking about here. So essentially, the simplicity of packaging such a meme coin, it's the reason why it became really successful, because you have people, communities building, saying, hey, we can, I was developing art and I was being paid in Dogecoin. I was doing this and I was being paid in Dogecoin. And people are consuming the idea of cryptocurrency through fun, because they don't want to go through this whole process of, you know, make a wallet. This wallet is a hexadecimal number, and then you have private keys. I mean, those things still exist in Dogecoin, but at least they try to wrap some of the other complexity in terms of a meme. But then you get into the security part, because talked about the scalability, so the issuance of the tokens, and which keeps the price down, which helps with scalability. So we have security, where the consensus algorithms come in. So you can run a node, that's where so decentralization come in. You can run something we call a node, where you get a bunch of Doge. You're running a proof of, well, that's proof of stake, where you need a bunch of cryptos, but this is a proof of work model where you solve a mathematical algorithm to keep the network secure. As long as less than 50% of nodes control the network, then it should remain secure. So these are some of the, so you have a funny digital currency that is robust, that is being accelerated by some billionaire through essentially brought onto Twitter and put in everyone's faces on this platform, which leads to this excitement. And now, that whole excitement of, you know, Twitter, Dogecoin, meme coins, ease to consume and so on, led to the birth of a bunch of other meme coins, led by Shiba Inu. Now, Shiba Inu is a token that was started by a person or a group of people that call themselves Ryoshi. Now, before we get into Shiba Inu, I mean, before we get into if there are any advantages or disadvantages, one of the pitfalls I see is because, I mean, these guys, when you look at their white paper, it's literally the tokenomics are based off, we gave 50% of our tokens to Vitalik Buterin, and Buterin, hopefully, if he doesn't rug pull us, we're going to go to the moon. So Vitalik donates a bunch of Shiba Inu at the time it was really, really famous, and where from the lowest price to the highest price, Shiba Inu saw like 100 million or 150 million% in increase in price. It was ridiculous. In other words, if you invested like $1,000 in Shiba Inu at this lowest price, that would have been close to $1 billion. I mean, that kind of value is insane. So they gave half of their supply to Vitalik, because these are pseudonymous cryptocurrencies, are pseudonymous addresses are public, which means you can send any token to any address as long as it's compatible with that ecosystem. So Shiba Inu being an ERC20 token or based off Ethereum, you could send your tokens onto any Ethereum wallet, essentially. And actually, they're actually creating another version, a layer two, that's going to support. So the disadvantage I was talking about, so you have a bunch of trillions of tokens. Half of them were given to Vitalik. He gave away to an Indian COVID relief kind of campaign. He gave away $1 billion worth, and I think sent the rest to a burn wallet. So which means he's not going to rug pull the community. So you have their white paper based off that. That is our tokenomics. And then you have the creator Ryoshi saying that they do not own any tokens themselves. Well, the group or him or her or whatever they are, they do not own any tokens themselves, and they have this altruism of, you know, just creating something that's innocent, something that's funny, something that's also based off memes, based off the Dogecoin, because in Dogecoin the main character is a Shiba Inu dog. So you have the cryptocurrency called Shiba Inu, and out of that popularity, what they decide to do, they decide to do, I think the thing that's a terrible idea, split the ecosystem. I mean, they're claiming that they don't want to have this inflationary nature of their tokens, which means they're going to continuously burn them. So what they do is create a bunch of other tokens called, there's Bone and then there's Leash. Oh, so if you stake Shiba Inu tokens, then you're going to get these other tokens called Bone tokens. And then if you've been a long-term supporter, you're going to have these Leash tokens. And one of those tokens is a governance token, so you can vote on policies, or you can vote on developments, or, you know, vote against developments within the Shiba Inu ecosystem. So you have this sort of superficial a growth of something that has been built from the excitement of the success of Dogecoins or the idea of meme coins, and you have the emergence of a bunch of other meme coins. And essentially, that's where we are in the cryptocurrency space. We do not understand where we are. When you look at the white paper of Shiba Inu, for instance, it tends to mimic the Dogecoin idea of bad language, I mean, bad grammar, sort of to bring out that humorous nature. It's it tries to bring out that funny side of crypto based on a supposed altruistic idea or approach to the crypto space that's not driven by greed or profit expectations, while at the same time splitting the ecosystem into multiple other tokens that obviously the developers are going to hold, hoping that this accidental community that has been created around that ecosystem gets a hold of these tokens through staking or through other mechanism, and the whole speculative nature comes in. So I mean, the whole rotation of the same thing they wanted to run away from is where they get back to. You know, we have this altruistic nature, but oh, all of a sudden our tokens are blown. But there's no way of proving that they didn't own any tokens, because you just, the pseudonymous nature of cryptocurrencies, you can hide what you have. And then on the other end, they create a whole bunch of tokens that are going to obviously extend liquidity to them or to any other people that hold a bunch of tokens. And the whole thing is a money-making thing. Hey, don't get me wrong. I have no issue with making money, because at the core, that is the idea of cryptocurrencies. At least that's where we are right now. I mean, at the core of cryptocurrencies, it's truly democratization of money. It's truly democratization of money. It's truly taking us away from the banking system that we know of to a self-custody type of system where a user can bounce around in multiple currencies and not just limited to the, you know, geographical currencies that are tied onto countries. So not only can you bounce around into currencies of other countries very, very easily, but you can also bounce around into currencies mimicking gold, mimicking silver, and also you can bounce around in currencies that are native on the internet. So these are tokens based around open source communities that are excited about them. These are based around tokens that are maybe trying to innovate in AI or build smart contracts like Ethereum, or tokens that are building as layer two technologies, trying to scale other ecosystems. I mean, this whole thing expands. Tokens trying to democratize data, democratize AI, democratize interoperability. So we have, you know, we're come out as an ecosystem that's going to help every token in the crypto space talk to each other. And therefore, we're going to extend that value through different ecosystems. And we're going to build a whole bunch of things so this value can be extended there. And if you're doing a proof of stake mechanism, you're going to be able to leverage maximum extractable value and all these bad buzzwords out there. So is such the cryptocurrency space in its current state. It's a whole bunch of confusion. It's a whole bunch of smart people. It's a whole bunch of money lost, money gained, a whole, like, but at the core, we understand that there is a way to transact over the internet right now. So this video was mostly focused on the meme coins, but there's a whole bunch of trends that are happening in the space, like decentralized finance, which was essentially ERC-20 tokens, or making tokens but packaged in another way. So you have ideas or terminologies like liquid farming, staking, you can liquid pools and so on. All that terminology and many others emerged in the previous bull market before we got into the current state of the bear market, and we're yet to see what next comes into the crypto space. I don't know what other trend is going to emerge. Some say it's going to be the AI trend, so we'll see. All right guys, thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next one. Take care. Bye bye.